In a previous video, I showed you what happens when you wire two speakers with opposite polarity. This video will build upon that concept, but let's do a quick recap in case you missed that video. A speaker's polarity is determined by its connection to the amplifier. If you wire both speakers the same way, they'll work together, and the energy from each speaker will sum together to create a louder signal for the listener. Here in the DAW, I have two copies of a signal. When I play one copy at a time, the signal level meter reads minus 18 dB. And when I play them together, the signal meter reads minus 12 dB, an increase of 6 dB. But let's say you wire one speaker with correct polarity, positive to positive and negative to negative, and one speaker with inverted polarity, positive to negative and negative to positive. Now the speakers work against each other. When one speaker creates a positive pressure change, the other creates a negative pressure change, resulting in cancellation. I have two copies of the signal again. This time I'll invert one copy. Notice that now the positive phases of this copy line up with the negative phases of this copy. Each copy alone will still read minus 18 dB on the meter, but when I play them together, they completely cancel each other out. While this is helpful for understanding the mechanics of constructive and destructive interference, wiring speakers with opposite polarity rarely results in a complete cancellation in practice. Let's demonstrate that by playing a stereo signal through your speakers. I'll start with the same polarity in both the left and right speaker, then I'll invert the polarity of one of them. If you're listening on headphones, the effect is quite odd because none of the signal from the left side reaches your right ear, and none of the signal from the right side reaches your left ear. In speakers, the signals will cancel when they interact acoustically, but you'll notice they don't completely cancel, as they did in my electrical demonstration a moment ago. That's largely because in my electrical demonstration, there was only one dimension, while the acoustic space you're listening in has three dimensions, which makes things a lot more complicated to predict. I think another demo would be helpful here. I've got two speakers and a microphone. When I play the signal only out of the left speaker, we'll see minus 18 dB on the level meter for the microphone input. And the same thing will happen if I mute the left speaker and only play the signal out of the right speaker. These two speakers are currently wired with the same polarity. So what do you think will happen when I play both speakers together? It results in a greater signal level, but it's not exactly a 6 dB increase because there are more factors at play. More on that in a moment. What do you think will happen when I invert the polarity of one of these speakers? The combined level is less than either speaker alone, but the signal doesn't completely cancel out as it did in the electrical demonstration. One reason for that is that there are more sounds in this room than just this signal, so even if it did completely cancel at the microphone, you'd still hear the sound of my fan on my computer, for example. Another reason is that we're hearing indirect sound that's reflected off of nearby surfaces and back to the microphone. And another reason is that the mic may not be perfectly aligned. Maybe it's slightly closer to one speaker than the other, which creates a slight time offset between them, causing the signals to partially cancel rather than totally cancel. Watch what happens when I deliberately move the microphone closer to one speaker. Remember, each speaker alone was about minus 18 dB on the meter, but now the meter level increases beyond that even though the speakers are wired with opposite polarity. How is that possible? A moment ago, we saw that waves could partially cancel when there's a slight offset between them. At a certain point, with a large enough time offset, the waves actually sum together again. And if you keep delaying one signal, they'll eventually totally cancel again. When two copies of a signal arrive at different times, there will be phase interference. This is a big challenge in the world of sound system design because it means people sitting in different locations throughout the room will experience the sound differently. If the speakers are wired with the same polarity, the signal from each speaker will work together for the person in the center of the room, who's an equal distance away from each speaker. But the speakers might work against one another from the perspective of a person sitting off to one side. Unfortunately, it gets even more complicated when dealing with a signal containing many frequencies, like music. That's because each frequency has a unique wavelength, which means the same time offset will result in different levels of interference at different frequencies. In the DAW, we can visualize this. Instead of two copies of one frequency, let's make two copies of a group of frequencies. Right now, they all align in time. If I invert the polarity of one of them, they'll completely cancel. But if I shift one group of frequencies back in time, some frequencies will sum together and some will cancel out. The amount of phase interference depends on the wavelength of each frequency relative to the time shift. Listen to the effect this has in the physical world when I play many different frequencies through each of these speakers and move the microphone between them. In the next video, I'll help you understand more about what's going on here, a phenomenon called comb filtering. Go ahead and click that link now, and I'll see you there.